Hello, today I'm going to show you how to make this smart mirror that says things like the day, the news, the date, the calendar, and the holidays. If you want to make one, watch the full video and like it. Well, the first thing is to get a glass the size of the mirror you want. I made it 40 by 60 because 40 was the width of my monitor. So, corresponding to the monitor you have, choose the corresponding glass. Clean it well, so that obviously we can stick the film, which is a mirrored film. That's how I bought it. It's not really the most recommended, but it was the only thing that was available in my country. Really, the best thing is to use a two-way glass, but it doesn't exist here. So I used one of these mirrored polarized glasses that are generally used for showcases and things like that in businesses. You have to put it on a mixture of water and soap to the glass and the film once you peel it off, as you saw in the video. The part that sticks, let's say like a sticker, and what the water with soap does is make it more slippery so that once we stick it, it doesn't stay stuck. And we can manipulate it to get all the bubbles out with a spatula, making this movement to get all the bubbles out and all the imperfections that remained in the film from the inside, always from the middle outwards. So nothing remains encapsulated, and once it is very smooth, cut off the excess. Don't be bothered if the glass moves a bit at this moment, because it's normal, due to the remaining soap residue. For the frame, I used a wooden board or strip of the thickness that seemed most convenient to me, and I cut the angles at 45 degrees. They have to make it 1 centimeter smaller than the total size of the mirror, let's say. Since the mirror has to rest on the frame because otherwise it would come out through the middle. Once you have presented everything and all the edges are more or less good, what I did was glue them with glue and then staple them with the stapler. There's probably a better way to join them, but honestly, I didn't think of it. I also don't have the tools to make those joints, but it still turned out very well. It didn't come out and it was quite strong. We are also going to make the internal structure with the same wood, which is basically a frame that will house the glass in our monitor at the back, which we will talk about later. It's just a frame that you then screw to the structure you had previously made. It has to fit very tightly so that the mirror doesn't dance inside or so that the monitor doesn't move or things like that. The monitor I chose to use is a 19-inch widescreen monitor, which is actually quite small for these applications. Generally, it's best to use a monitor that covers the entire mirror. That way, we have the whole mirror with a screen. But still, this is a good way, and it's a much cheaper way, since a 40 by 60 monitor. The project would be about 30 inches and quite expensive for something that isn't really justified. It looks very good like this either way. What I did was remove all the plastic so they wouldn't bother. Besides, the plastic gives it a lift that I didn't want to have. And you have to put it in the part where you are going to want the screen part of the monitor. I mean, it's always on the top part because that's where it fits best. But if you want it in the middle, you put the monitor in the middle. The part without a monitor, the mirror, needs to be covered with a blackout that does not allow the passage of light, and that is black. Then you can fasten it or put it however you want. I grabbed it with some clamps. This is so that the light does not interfere from behind the mirror and you see stains or things like that and nothing. Once you do it, I cleaned it because it was quite dirty. And in the joints that did not stay perfect, let's say, I put pine putty, wood putty for pine with a spatula that can then be sanded. And it looks excellent, as if I really got it right the first time. But, well, as my carpentry skills are not very good, there's always a solution later to fix it. Then what I did was varnish it with a natural varnish, with a natural color, because I like these light colors. And I covered the mirror with tape so as not to stain anything. Actually, it is best to varnish it before putting the mirror. But well, nothing happens if you varnish it later. Put a little tape and that's it. The truth is that I really like the varnish. As I already said, it is a varnish almost without color. It is more than anything for protection against the sun and things like that. We will use a Raspberry with pre-installed Raspbian for the software, assuming you have Raspbian pre-installed. If not, I'll provide a link in the description on how to install it. It's very simple. I will provide the library we'll be using, which is Magic Mirror. Two is a popular option. Copy the link from the page and paste it into the SSH terminal of your Raspberry Pi. And it's going to install absolutely everything. Then we're going to go to this page, which is OpenWinter, to get our credentials for the weather data. This is very important. You have to go here. And fill it out with your data. Click on Create Account, and they will send you the Android package by mail that you have to put in the Magic Mirror configuration file that you're going to access by entering the command, also the SSH that I'm going to leave in the description, or simply by editing the file that is in the command. Then we're going to go to the Calendar Labs page, and you're going to search for your country and copy the link as I copied it and replace it in the file too. This is to have the list of holidays. You can also search any news page and copy its RSS link and also paste it in the description. This is more or less a quick explanation because in reality, you can stop to see all the settings you have. In fact, you have a lot of external plugins that you can also review. And once you have set everything more or less to your liking, you can give a preview of what your Magic Mirror is going to be. Your mirror, this, as I already told you, has a lot of settings that you can check in the link that I'm going to leave in the description, where you can check the complete settings and a lot of plugins from other people that have already been made and their own settings and their own add-ons and plugins for this type of mirrors. Then all that's left is to put everything in its place, put the cable. I used an HDMI adapter because my monitor didn't support HDMI. Connect it to the Raspberry, tidy everything up, connect the power supply, which is the common USB cable, like the ones for cell phones, better if it's connected to the wall. And then in the USB ports, you can plug in a mouse or keyboard or, well, whatever you want. I also adjusted the brightness of the monitor to have the highest contrast possible. This depends on the monitor, as you want. And we have our mirror finished. As you can see, it looks better with the light off. It's much more noticeable with daylight or without a light hitting it head on. Also, for example, by pressing the Windows key, if you have connected a keyboard, you can access a browser or put or YouTube, search for news or whatever you want. The mirror always updates itself. And with the settings I made, it shows the weather. It shows the holidays. It shows the news from the InfoBase site. It shows a message that you can pre-configure in the middle. You can put whatever you want and some other more interesting things. I'm going to leave you the configuration file of how I did it so you can just copy and paste it and it will work for you. And if you like this video, subscribe and see you in the next one. Thank you.